And yeah, I hope you're excited, and I'm very glad you are here. And I hope you are feeling creative, and maybe you are a bit stressed, or you know, you don't know what to do. So what I do is, just to loosen up, I keep all my tool slips. Then I recycle them, you know, and I make collages on them. On my channel, there's quite a few ideas, and I've made collages before on a full video. But now I'm just in the mood because I've got quite a few slips now, and I just want to, otherwise it can be very daunting if you keep them all, you know, all the plastics, all the, it can soon look like a nightmare in your house. So I just want to quickly just do something to be creative, and then to make this a bit more space in my recycle bucket. That is a lot of glue. So let me just take it off a bit. Oh, you can't see. Okay, so let's just do that. And I hope you can see now, because the setup I've got here is a bit weird. It's not my normal setup. But we have to carry on and make the best of what we've got. So there is our tool slips together now. And now we can just start, you know, what you can do now is you can decide, okay, do I want to make it a fabric collage piece or just paper? And so I'm just busy, you see that small tool slip, that is, I'm just going to use that as well and then just make a little collage quickly. Because most of the time I do, you know, the paper, because the paper is always, you know, a lot of papers everywhere, so it's easy to just use that quickly. If you feel your table is getting too messy, then that is one way to get rid of all that. And so what I usually do is, I put all the tool slips together, like I showed you now, and then I will just put them aside. You can use toilet rolls, and then I roll it up on the toilet roll. And that helps me keep everything in place, and yeah, so it doesn't feel too overwhelming with all the slips and yeah. And I just made a video for how to make clusters from plastic. You know, the plastic wrapping that you use in your, from your art supplies and so on. So you can check out that video if you want to. And yeah, so this is just the easy way, and maybe you feel a bit stuck in your artwork, and then this is very easy just to get you into the swing of things, you know, just to loosen up a bit. Because sometimes we think too much. And see, there is your base for a cluster. So you can get two clusters out of it, or you can make two long ones. And you can do now, you know, just put some fabrics on there. And you can layer it as many layers as you want. I just want this as a base, so I can think later what I want to do. I'm just going to leave that one there. And yeah, so now we can just, I just want to get a glue book going here. See, that is so beautiful. I just want to lift that one up. so it can go underneath that. See there, I like that look there. And then we want a small strip. And this small strip you can just carry on that side. I'm going to leave that part there. See, just start collaging. No, don't think, just do it. I did work in from a magazine the other day, so I took all the pages that I didn't use. I just tore pieces of color. You see the color, and yeah, because I thought it can be easy, you know, beautiful if you then cut it later. Look at those colors there. And now this one I can lift up. Yeah, so very exciting. See, if you put fabrics on top of that, it can quickly become something. All of a sudden, it's so hot here. It was cold the whole morning. But now it's very, very hot. You know. Okay, see. I'm already feel calmer. And, yeah, so I don't know. I know Gail Agostinelli, she loves collaging. Just want to lift that up there. See, if the glue is too dry, then you can't lift up anymore. And I will be stitching. See, that side is also nice, but I'm still going to use this one here. See now there. And yeah, my mark making. I think I did a video on how to use the till slips for you know, for mark making as well. I painted on top of it, and that is also easy. If you've got it now on a toilet roll, you know, then you can just grab one, and as you know, while you're painting, and then clean your brushes on it. Then it's already halfway. Oh yeah, yeah, I must say I am so hot now. I'm just looking for some pages. You know, I'm so stingy with my coffee dyed papers. And I don't know why, because I can always make more. It does take a lot of time to just do it, because it takes me a whole day to make a few, you know, because you can't just make one here and there. Okay, I want some okay, I want some music paper. Look at this lovely paper. Just for some extra texture. I'm just going to put that over that part that I glued. If there's any hard parts on your book, take it off before, because if you're going to stitch over it, because I can feel here that book page has got some hard glue still. So I'm just taking that off, because you can hurt your machine. I'm on the roll here now. Yeah, beautiful. It's almost like if you make the book pages, you know, you collage on book pages and your master board. Let me just get some other paper. These I painted on the book page. See, this is what I did with the cleaning my brushes. I want that one underneath there. Okay. And then later you can just come. And you can put lace on top of it. Let me see if I've got some lace here. You see, you put lace on it and pieces of fabric. And then it will immediately transform the whole collage page. And it doesn't matter if it's too big, you know, like there, going off the page. This is a piece of tape that I used to make the concertina book. And I did the, yeah, see, that is now the other one that I used, the tall slips. I made a concertina book, a collaging concertina book that you can also find in my videos. I'm just going to do that one there. See, it's, you mustn't think too much, because this is just to get you started. See, this one I can put on that side as well. Let me just do it. Oops. I'm going to put it on this part here. Like that. And then this one I'll do here. Yeah, I'm just using what is on my desk, and it makes it exciting, because then you have to just the thing that you've got in your hand, put it down. I did a course with another artist. I forgot her name now. And yeah, she does collaging. And she also says, just what you've got in your hand, just put it down. Otherwise, we overthink. See, there's faces now, but it doesn't matter because you're gonna still put other stuff on top of it. And you never know for what you're gonna use this, so it's okay just to layer and layer. I'm not sure if I'm going to use that one. I hope you can still see. And then, yeah, I can't, yeah, I'm not even going to say it. Because they say you must do what's in front of you and just make the best of what you've got at the moment and say thanks for every little bit you do have. I'm trying to live by that. I must say I'm very one-sided, you know, it's the big pieces on this side. My paper is getting a bit thin over here. You don't want to see the rest of this table. Oh, I love this. This was on a plate, you know, one of the magazines. Just makes such a beautiful piece of interesting spot. Okay, let me just see. And yeah, let me see, my papers is a bit, let me think. There's no time for thinking, you must just do. See this one, I want, where did I see that other spot that was open there? I can just do it there. See, I like that where the letter comes through. Okay, only a little piece still. Then we are done for the day. Our collage bits. I did this also on the, I worked in a shop the one day, and just to keep me busy, I did this on a brown paper bag. Somewhere with anything that I could find in the drawer, you know, a pen, pencil. Yeah, I did quite a few of that. And you just see that little piece of interesting part there now. Just a few marks and... Okay, my paper is getting... Put that one there. Oh, this is exciting. See, if you've got the papers, then it's nice. If you have to go make it now, you know, the painted papers, then it will take you a long time. But now, while I was doing the working in the shop, I just did those papers. And the other ones, I just cleaned my brush off. And it makes life just a bit easier for you. Okay, just a little bit more. Sorry for that. Was so hot here now, and now it's cooler again because I could see the glue as well. It started doing weird things. I really hope I'm in screen, because then otherwise I will take the videos down and then I'll make it, I'll do a better job. You can do it faster. I'm enjoying myself now so much. I'm just lifting that up. Yeah, and then it would be so interesting to see what it will become. I'm just tearing some more paper. Okay, just one little piece. I'm just not gonna take that one. I know it's a bit, but it doesn't matter. You can always do something on top of it. Okay, just for extra textures and so on. You know, this glue is now a total mess. Okay, so, but that is now our till slips into collage page, or I don't know if you want to call it a snippet roll or what. But you can do with it what you want now. You can cut it, you can tear it, you can put more things on top of it. And yeah, and there's the tool slips gone. And you've got the extra papers to work on. You can always cut it and then paint on top of it with gesso. And yeah, and make a painting on this. And then that can go on a card. Yeah, or on a book page. Can you see now you've got your book page, and then you can make a tuck spot or a belly band. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll speak to you soon. And if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel and give it a thumbs up. I would appreciate it. Have a good day. Bye.